So in this video, I want to talk to you about isolating parts of the image so that we can individually adjust them and make them stand out. So with that in mind, this video, we're going to concentrate on the next option available to us, which is select sky. So let me show you how we can get from this before photo to this after utilizing automated masking and select sky. So what we're gonna do with this photo open inside of Lightroom, I'm gonna click on this masking icon on the bottom left here, and then I'm gonna click on that blue circle with the plus icon. That's gonna bring up my masking options. And we did select subject before, so now we're gonna do select sky. And these are the two main automated tools that we have available to us that will automatically select what it is that we want to mask. So here's what I think is gonna improve the sky. We want some color contrast. We want some vibrancy in the photo. We want a good reason to look at that sky and make it interesting. So I'm gonna click on the color option here at the bottom. That's gonna give me my color temperature adjustment sliders. So I'm gonna click and hold on the temperature slider and simply drag it to the left. And as I do, you're gonna notice that we're getting cooler and cooler tones. Let's go right around here. Let's do maybe 40 or so. I think that's a really good place. Just making that sky blue all of a sudden gives us a little bit more contrast with the rest of the photo between the warm and the cool. So how can we improve this a little bit more? Now, I think there's a little bit of detail in the sky, but I want to bring out a little bit more detail too. I really want to draw the viewer's eye and make the sky just a little bit more interesting. So I'm going to click on effects and I'm going to find my clarity slider here and just drag that to the right. Maybe just 5 or 10 points. We'll leave it at 10. Now I want to duplicate that mask and adjust what's not the sky, making that stand out and applying our adjustments or local adjustments to what's not the sky. Let's take a look at how we do that. I'm gonna click on the checkbox here. We have our first mask done. I'm gonna click on the mask panel again. So now I wanna pay your attention to the right-hand side. And just like we did previously, you'll see a little white vertical line here next to those masks. If I drag it to the left, it will slide open the panel that shows me a little bit more information and gives me some text that shows us what we're looking at here. So what it's doing is showing us that we have one mask applied already. Now, if I wanted to do the opposite of what I just did, instead of select the sky, I want to select what's not the sky. I can click on these three dots next to this mask. And now I have the option to not just duplicate, but I want to duplicate and invert. And now we have a duplicate mask that's inverted, so I'm selecting what's not the sky. I'm going to drag that vertical slider back to the right, so we can get rid of that menu and we see a little bit more of the image that we're gonna edit. So what do we do next? How do we improve this photo further? Now, what caught my eye when I first took this image is that the highlights were just a little bit too bright. So let's correct that. I'm gonna click on lights here, and I'm gonna grab my highlights and I'm gonna drag them down. So I'm just gonna drag this a little bit, maybe around negative 15. There we go. Now this is just looking a little bit better to me. They're not as blown out. So next, what stood out to me, especially in the buildings and the skyline in the background, there was a little bit of a green color cast. For me, that's a distraction. So how do we offset that green color cast? Well, if we open up our color panel here and we have our tint slider, I'm gonna slide this towards the opposite color of green, which is magenta. I'm gonna make this maybe 30. So what I'm noticing also is that the image is just a little bit too soft here. If I want to make this image really pop, I want to take those details and really make them stand out. And we know already how to do this. We're going to click on our effects tab and we have at our fingertips the option to adjust the texture and the clarity as well as the dehaze. So I'm going to start with texture first. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit here so you can see what I'm doing. I'm going to grab that texture slider here at the top and I'm going to drag that quite a bit. Maybe around here. Let's go to about 60. Next up, I want to add even more detail. So I'm going to grab my clarity slider and drag it to around 40 or so. So that's really starting to take shape now. You can already see the details start to pop out in this photo. So we're going to click on the checkbox at the bottom right. We're going to look at our before and after here. Now that we did our local adjustment, so there's just a few more things I think that we can do to really sell this image. The first thing we want to do is add just a little bit more color to the image. So we have a panel for that. I'm going to click on our color panel here. I'm going to drag up a little bit until I see the word vibrance. So I'm going to move this slider to the right, just increasing the color in the image to about, let's say, 20. So the next thing we need to do is adjust some more details in the photo on a global level. We just want to make it pop just a little bit more. So I'm going to click on the effects panel here and I want to instantly grab my clarity slider, move that to the right just a little bit. maybe around 30 or so. Next, I'm gonna grab my dehaze slider, drag that to the right. Next, I wanna go to my vignette. I just wanna darken the edges of the frame. So I'll go to negative 10. That's looking good. So I'm gonna click on the detail tab here. I'm gonna grab my slider for sharpening and just drag that to the right. I think 90 is gonna look pretty good. And any time that we're gonna adjust sharpening, you do want to mask out that sharpening too. We don't wanna sharpen the sky. We only wanna sharpen the skyline and all the other details that are in the photo. I'm gonna click on that masking slider. As I drag that to the right, I'm gonna tap and hold on the screen. And right around, I think, let's do 60. There we go. Now, before I let go of this mask, look what's happening. It's just finding those details, just finding those hard lines of the image. That's what I wanna emphasize. So I'll let go, and that was the final touch. There's my before, and there's my after. So here's the takeaway: to make individual, targeted, localized adjustments to parts of the image that need it. And conversely, not make those adjustments to the part of the image that doesn't. And when we do that, we're gonna walk away with a much more powerful image. This video was a free preview of the iPhone Editing Academy online course. In this course, you'll discover everything you need to know to edit your photos to perfection using the device that's always in your pocket. Whether you want to breathe new life into your old images or make your best photos even better, you'll find out exactly how to do that on your iPhone. I'll show you the latest photo editing tricks that will transform even average photos into stunning masterpieces in just a few minutes. So if you'd like to learn more about creating incredible photo edits on your iPhone, please take a look at the full version of my iPhone Editing Academy course. You'll find the link in the description right next to this video. So click on that link now, and I'll see you inside the full version of this course.